नमस्ते एवरीवन, दिस इज माथुरी एट साइंस एट योर टिप्स. वेलकम बैक टू अनदर सेशन. हियर वी वर डिस्कसिंग फोर्स एंड लॉस ऑफ मोशन इन टेक्स्ट क्वेश्चंस. सो लेट अस सी द एग्जांपल प्रॉब्लम्स व्हाट आर गिवन हियर. अ कांस्टेंट फोर्स एक्ट्स ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ मास 5 केजी फॉर अ ड्यूरेशन ऑफ 2 सेकेंड्स. इट इंक्रीजेस ऑब्जेक्ट्स वेलोसिटी फ्रॉम 3 मीटर्स पर सेकेंड टू 7 मीटर्स पर सेकेंड. फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द अप्लाइड फोर्स. Now, the force was applied for a duration of 5 seconds. What would be the final velocity of the object? Let us see the solution for this question. Now, here in this question, if you observe, they have given both initial velocity and final velocity. Initial velocity is given as 3 meters per second and final velocity is given as 7 meters per second. And here if you see, time also is given. So time we can take it as 2 seconds. From these all values, let us find out what is acceleration. Acceleration, you know already that it is a rate of change in velocity. A is equal to V minus U by T. So here we are going to get the value as 7 minus 3 by 2. That is nothing but 4 by 2, 2 meters per second square. Then, we have to find out what is the applied force. Magnitude of applied force we have to find out. So, what we have to do here to find out that magnitude of applied force, we are going to write the formula F is equal to ma, which we have derived already from our second law of motion. Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma. And here in the question itself, they have given m value as, the value is given as 5 kilograms. 5 kilograms. So what we can do here, force is equal to 5 into 2. Because mass is already given in the question and acceleration we have found out, 2 meters per second square. 5 into 2, we are going to get the value as 10 newtons. This is a force, magnitude of the applied force. Then what we have to do here, we have to find out if the force was applied for a duration of 5 seconds, what would be the final velocity of the object. Let us find out that also. Here, time is given as 5 seconds. Time is given as 5 seconds. Okay. And initial velocity is given in the question itself, 3 meters per second. V value we have to find out, A value we got already, that is 2 meters per second square. 2 meters per second square is the value of acceleration. Now what we can do, we can find out V value. What is the formula we have here? V is equal to U plus AT. That is, U value we have already 3 plus A value. A value we have 2 into time we have 5. So, what we'll get here? 3 plus 10. That is nothing but 13 meter per second. If the force applied for 5 seconds, then the final velocity of the object will be 13 meters per second. Then, we'll see the next problem. So, this is our next question in example problems. Which would require a greater force? Accelerating a 2 kg mass at 5 meters per second square or 4 kg mass at 2 meters per second square. Let us see the solution for this. Now here in this question, if you observe in 9.2 example, we have seen that two masses are given. Let us take the first mass as M1 and this mass is given as 2 kg and they are saying that acceleration is given here. I am taking this as A1. This acceleration is given as 5 meters per second square. Then, we are going to find out what is the force applied on this object. F1 is equal to M1 A1. So, what we can write here, 2 into 5. That is nothing but 10 newtons. Now, let us see about the second object. M2 value. That is the mass of second object. Here in the question, they have given that it is 4 kilograms. Then acceleration is given here as, what is the value of acceleration given? 2 meters per second square. So what we will get the force applied on this object to get the acceleration of 2 meters per second square? We are going to find out with the help of the formula F is equal to ma. So I am writing this formula as F2 is equal to m2 into a2. That is nothing but 4 into 2. 4 into 2. We are going to get the value as 8 newtons. So here if you observe F1 value and F2 value, you have observed that F1 is greater than F2. 10 newtons F1 value and 8 newtons F2 value. So that is why we can say that accelerating a 2 kg mass at 5 meters per second, 5 meters per second square, would require a greater force than the force applied on 4 kg of mass to get acceleration of 2 meters per second square. Let us see the next question. Here we have the next question, example 9.3. A motor car is moving with a velocity of 108 km per hour and it takes 4 seconds to stop after the brakes are applied. Calculate the force exerted by the brakes on the motor car if its mass along with the passengers is 1000 kg. Let us see the solution for this question. So from the question, it is clear that the velocity of this motor car is given as 108 km by hour. So we will take this one as, in 9.3 example, we will take this u value as 108 km by hour. With this value, we can't calculate because it is given in kilometer per hour. Remaining values are there in MKS system. So that's why better you convert this also into MKS system. So what we will get here, 108 into 5 by 18. By multiplying with 5 by 18, we can convert kilometer per hour value into meters per second. Okay, so what we will get here, the answer as 30 meters per second. Because in already 18 into 6 is nothing but 18 into 6 is nothing but 108. So, 18 and 108, if you are cancelling here, we will get 6. 6 into 5 is nothing but 30 meters per second. Then, here, they are saying that motor car is going to, the brakes are applied in that motor car to stop that. So, as they have given final velocity 0, we can take brakes are applied and the motor car is stopping there. So, here we got V value 0, U value 30 meters per second. And the time is given as 4 seconds. Time is given as 4 seconds. Now let us find out what is the acceleration value. Acceleration is equal to V minus U by T. Because you know already acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity. V minus U by T. Final velocity minus initial velocity by time. So what we will get here? 0 minus 30 divided by 4. 0 minus 30 divided by 4, what we will get here? We are going to get the value as minus 7.5 meters by second square. 30 by 2, if it is there, we will get 15. But 30 by 4 is there. So, 15 by 2, that is nothing but minus 7.5. Now, we will continue the calculation. We got only acceleration up to now. But here, we have to find out what is the force exerted by the brakes on the motor car. And just to try to remember here, when motor car is traveling in one direction, brakes have to be applied in the opposite direction. So compulsory, this force whatever is applied, we are going to get the negative value. You have to get the force as negative value. Already we got acceleration in the form of negative values only, minus 7.5 meters per second square. So let us find out what is the force. So force is equal to ma. So here m value we got already in the question itself, we got it. Along with the passengers, a motor car is having the mass of 1000 kilograms. Okay, 1000 kilograms into minus 7.5 meters per second square. That is the value of acceleration. So what we will get the answer here, 7.5 into 1000, we are going to get 7500. We have to put the minus sign here, don't forget that, and newtons. So minus 7500 newtons is a force applied on the motor car, so that we can apply the brakes on that. The brakes are applied and the force is exerted in opposite direction to the direction of the motor car. That's why we have to get the value compulsory in negative. Okay, let us see the next question. The next question is given as, a force of 5 newtons gives a mass m1, an acceleration of 10 meters per second square, and a mass m2, an acceleration of 20 meters per second square. What acceleration would it give if both the masses were tied together? So from this question, what we can understand, two different masses are there, m1 and m2. When you are applying 5 newtons on first one, then we are going to get the acceleration of 10 meters per second square. And when you apply the force, the same force, 5 newtons on the second object, we are going to get the acceleration of 20 meters per second square. But if this M1 and M2 are tied together, then what acceleration we are going to get? Same force again we are going to apply. Now let us see the solution for this question. Now, let us see the first one. First object mass is given as M1. Okay. And force is given as 5 newtons. As force is similar in every case, I am not writing this as F1, F2 like that. I will simply write it as F. So force applied on this M1 mass is 5 newtons. So we are going to get the acceleration. Different accelerations are there. So that's why I wanted to give the number for this. So, A1 value we are going to get for this particular object as 10 meters per second square. And next, second one is there, M2. Before that, what we will do? First of all, we will find out this M1. What is the value for this? Because we have here force 5 newtons, acceleration 10 meters per second square. We can find out easily what is the mass. Because we have the formula, F is equal to ma. So, here in this case, I will write it as m1a1. Okay, so from this what we can do, we can find out what is the mass of this object. M1 is equal to F by A1. F value we have 5 newtons divided by 10, that we are going to get it as 0.5 kilograms. Mass is there, so that's why we have to write the units as kilograms. So 0.5 kilograms we got the answer for first object mass. The same manner we are going to find out the second object also. So for this mass M2, force you are applying the same thing, no, 5 newtons. Then what is the acceleration we are having here? A2. That is, what is the value here? A2 value here given as 20 meters per second square. 20 meters by second square. So what we can write here from our Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma. So here in this case I am writing it as F is equal to m2a2. From this we can find out m2 value. M2 is equal to f by a2. So what we are going to get here? 5 by 20. So 5 by 10 anyway we got 0.5 kg. So 5 by 20 what we will get? Less than that, means half of that, 0.25 kilograms. Now these two masses are tied together. So, total mass, I am writing it as M, that is equal to M1 plus M2. Okay. Now, here M1, M2 values already we got from this calculation. What is the value? 0.5 plus 0.25. So, what will get here the answer? 0.75 kilograms. 0.75 kilograms. Then we are going to find out what is the acceleration. Anyway, force is given as same. Same force is applied when these objects are tied together also. So what we can do here, we are going to find out what is the acceleration. Acceleration is equal to, what is the formula we have? We already know F is equal to ma. So a is equal to what we can write? F by m. What is F value here? What is F value here? 5. So let us write this. 5 divided by m value we got 0.75. So, 5 by 0.75. When you are getting a doubt to calculate this type of divisions or whether it is multiplication or whatever it is there, directly if you are able to do, you can do it. But Sometimes some students may get doubt because in MCQ, sometimes what happens is in points they are going to change the answer, like 0.75. For example, if the answer is something 0.8, there they may give the option as 0.08, 0.8, 8.0, like that. So there will be getting some little confusion. So that's why better what we can do is we can write these points, whatever are there here, in the form of divided by some number, divided by tens powers, or multiplied by tens powers. So what we can do here, 5 divided by 75 divided by 100, divided by 100, because 0.75 is there. After point we have 2 digits. So better we can write this in this form, 75 divided by 100. Or you can write 75 into 10 power minus 2. 75 into 10 power minus 2. Like that also we can write. So here what we will get, 5 into 100 divided by 75. Okay. So what we can find out here, we can write here as 100 means 25, with the 25 table we can cancel this now, 25 4 times, 25 3 times. So 5 into 4, 20 divided by 3. Now it became easy for us to calculate. 20 by 3, what we will get here, we are going to get the value as 6.6666, like that. So better to write this value as 6.67 meters by second square. Units also are very, very important here. We got here acceleration, that's why we are writing the units as meters by second square. Let us see the next question, children. So here we come to the next question, example 9.5. In this question, they have given some graph for us, velocity time graph, and velocity is not given in meters per second, it is given in centimeters per second, but time is given in seconds only. So let us see what is that question is. So they are giving here as, the velocity time graph of a ball of mass 20 grams moving along a straight line on a long table is given in figure 9.9. In graph they have given here. So if you observe this graph, once you can see, at the starting velocity of the ball is given as 20 centimeters per second, and finally it is stopping there because velocity is reaching as 0 after 10 seconds. Okay. So, time is given on x-axis, you can observe that, velocity is given on y-axis, but it is there in centimeters per second, observe that units also. Now, based on this graph, what we have to do, how much force does the table exert on the ball to bring it to rest? What is the force exerted by the table on the ball to bring it to rest? That we have to find out. So, we have the mass of the ball. We have initial velocity, final velocity, time. So we are going to find out acceleration first, and after that we'll find out force. But we have to remember, we should convert that centimeters per second. Velocity is given in centimeters per second. Convert that into meters per second. After that you can continue the calculations. We'll do that solution. So here in the question, as they have given the graph, from that graph it is clear that U value is 20 centimeters per second and V value is given as 0 centimeters per second, and we'll convert this U value into meters per second. What we have to do here? Anyway, seconds unit will be there in seconds only if you are converting that into MK system. So let us not touch that, but we have to convert the centimeters into meters, no? So what we can do here to convert that 20 centimeters when you are converting into meters. So we know already that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So what we have to do, centimeters we are converting into meters, no? So let us divide that with 100. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 power minus 2 meters. So 20 divided by 100 meters per second, that we are going to get it as 0.02 meters per second. Okay, U value we got 0.02 meters per second. The time, what is the time given from graph? Graph, reading the graph is very, very important. You have already learnt in motion lesson. So here also it is continued. T value is given according to the graph, it is 10 seconds. Okay. Now we are going to find out what is the acceleration. Acceleration, we know already it is the rate of change in velocity v minus u by t. So v value 0 minus 0.02 divided by time. What is the time? 10 seconds. So minus 0.02 divided by 10. Okay. So that we have here. Time is given in 10 seconds. Okay, here in this calculation, once if you observe, just a small mistake, 0.2 only, because 20 by 100, no, 0, 0 will get cancelled. 2 by 10 means nothing but 0.2. And here even 0.2 only. So what we'll get here, children, minus 0.2 divided by 10, we are going to get it as minus 0.02 meters by second square. Okay, this is the acceleration. Just see this divided by 100. Next, after that we are going to find out what is the acceleration, F, force. F is equal to ma. What is m value given here? The ball is having the mass of 20 grams. So 20 grams, but we have to convert this into kilograms, no? So what we have to do here, again, here also divide by 1000, because 20 grams we have to convert into kilograms. So F is equal to ma, that is nothing but 20 by 1000 into a value. A value what we have here, minus 0.02. Okay. Anyway, we know that force exerted by the ball, exerted by the table on the ball will be in opposite direction so that it can stop that. Okay. So 20 by 1000, what we are going to get the value here, 0, 0 will get cancelled. Here we are going to get 0.02 into acceleration we have minus 0.02. So finally what we are going to get, 2 into 2 anyway, 4. After point we have 2 digits here. Here also we have 2 digits. So after point we should have 4 digits in our answer. So what you can write after point, what you write? 3 zeros you put after that 4. Then total number of digits in your answer after point will be 4. So 0.0004. And units what we are going to write here, children? We are going to write the units as newtons. Okay. So these are few example problems, numerical problems, little bit confusing problems for us. But if you know the formula, if you know the conversions and all, it's very easy for doing. Right? Thank you, everyone. Thank you for watching.